C&J Consulting and Spoken Realms present Me, A Book of Remembrance by Winnifred Eaton, narrated by Jennifer Perree. 1. It was a cold, blizzardy day in the month of March when I left Quebec, and my weeping, shivering relatives made an anxious, melancholic group about my departing train. I myself cried a bit, with my face pressed against the window, but I was 17. My heart was light, and I had not been happy at home. My father was an artist, and we were very poor. My mother had been a tightrope dancer in her early youth. She was an excitable, temperamental creature from whose life all romance had been squeezed by the torturing experience of bearing 16 children. Moreover, she was the native of a far distant land, and I do not think she ever got over the feeling of being a stranger in Canada. Time was when my father, a young and ardent adventurer, an English-Irishman, had wandered far and wide over the face of the earth. The son of rich parents, he had sojourned to China and Japan and India in the days when few white men ventured into the Orient, but that was long ago. This story is frankly of myself, and I mention these few facts merely in the possibility of their proving of some psychological interest later. Also, they may explain why it was possible for a parent to allow a young girl of 17 to leave home with exactly $10 in her purse. I do not think my father knew just how much money I did have, to start upon a voyage to the West Indies. In any event, the fact remains that I had overruled my father's weak and absent-minded objections and my mother's exclamatory ones, and I had accepted a position in Jamaica, West Indies, to work for a little local newspaper called The Lantern. It all came about through my having written, at the age of 16, a crude but exciting story which a kindly friend, the editor of a Quebec weekly paper, actually accepted and published. I had always secretly believed there were strains of genius somewhere hidden in me. I had always lived in a little dream world of my own, wherein, beautiful and courted, I moved among the elect of the earth. Now I had given vivid proof of some unusual power. I walked on air. The world was rose-colored. Nay, it was golden. With my story in my hand, I went to the office of a family friend. I had expected to be smiled upon and approved, but also lectured and advised. My friend, however, regarded me speculatively. "I wonder," he said, "whether you couldn't take the place of a girl out in Jamaica who's anxious to return to Canada, but is under contract to remain there for 3 years." The West Indies? I had heard of the land somewhere, probably in my school geography. I think it was associated in my mind in some way with the fairy stories I read. Nevertheless, with the electricity and assurance of youth, I cried out that of course I would go. "It's a long way off," said my friend dubiously, "and you are very young." I assured him earnestly that I should grow, and as for the distance, I airily dismissed that objection as something too trivial to consider. Was I not the daughter of a man who had been back and forth to China no fewer than 18 times, and that during the perilous period of the Taiping Rebellion? Had not my father made journeys from the Orient in the old-fashioned sailing vessels, being at sea 100-odd days at a time? What could not his daughter do? Whatever impression I made upon this agent of the West Indian newspaper must have been fairly good, for he said he would write immediately to Mr. Campbell, the owner of the Lantern, who, by the way, was also a Canadian, and recommend me. I am not much of a hand at keeping secrets, but I did not tell my parents. I had been studying shorthand for some time, and now I plunged into that harder than ever, for the position was one with which I could utilize stenography. It was less than 2 weeks later when our friend came to the house to report that the West Indian editor had cabled for me to be sent at once. I was the fifth girl in our family to leave home. I suppose my father and mother had become sadly accustomed to the departing of the older children to try their fortunes in more promising cities.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.